David Gurevitz.
Yes.
Dan Arav.
Yes.
Shalom.
Shalom.
And welcome to CultureBuzz.
Thank you.
We are here for a very good reason that makes us very happy. After all, it's not every day that a new encyclopedia is coming out in Israel. So, congratulations for your new Encyclopedia of Ideas, dedicated to culture, thought, and media.
That's right.
What can you tell us about it?
Our encyclopedia is a peak of a long process. It took us 13 years of quite intensive work.
Bar mitzvah.
Yeah, bar mitzvah of quite intensive work. We started in back in 98. We're sort of doing something very small, dedicated to the coming millennium. We thought about making a small project with some new ideas that came up at that period, like millennium, like bug 2000. We thought about something quite modest. But as we started to work, David and me, we realized that it should be something much bigger, only because we enjoyed working together. So here we are, 13 years after, with a much bigger project than we expected. That's about it. That's about it.
I'm glad that we realized that, as you know, it's kind of eternity, project for the eternity. So we were quite, very relaxed because we knew it never would come to an end. So we were just, having fun writing. Insecure, these kind of words, because we didn't think a thought about the real world. I mean, this book coming out. It's a miracle if it's outside. It's a kind of miracle.
You were having too much fun to stop.
Yeah, and Danny, my partner, he always used to tell me, you cannot, say goodbye. You want to go on, to go on.
Yeah, I thought that David just don't want to stop. He just won't stop it because, I don't know, otherwise something very bad would happen. So we just kept on working with no finishing line. We didn't know what is really the ending point of this project.
But eventually you decided to stop.
Yeah,
eventually. What was the reason? 600 values or so?
We thought that we have said everything we have to say. Most of the important things we did succeed saying, so I thought, that's the good point to stop. The obvious reason is we were tired, we didn't know, we didn't have the energy, so we stopped. No, I think we thought that's it. We don't have to add to this. It's complete in a way. Our intuition told us this is the project, this is the book, okay. So
yeah, it's some inner feelings, something that you just feel it.
It's
really
intuition.
It's intuition.
It's male intuition.
Yeah.
Everything is intuition.
And I have to apologize, I didn't read all of it, only half.
Let's talk about things you did read.
But what is interesting here, many of the values are referring to modernity, to evolution.
Yeah.
And I find it a bit strange that in our times you found the time and you made the effort to write an encyclopedia. And today, at best, at least, especially when you look at the young generation, they use Wikipedia.
Yeah.
They hardly open a book. So there is a strong message here.
Yeah, I think the message is turned in two levels, mainly. The first one is being kind of alternative to Wikipedia. Because Wikipedia gives you mainly information and data. We thought that we need to offer a kind of a cultural analysis, deep analysis. We also thought that we want to do this kind of interrelationship between philosophy, communication, and culture terms. This kind of holistic thinking, which you cannot find in Wikipedia.
Right.
So it's a kind of...
Which is much more limited.
Yes.
And basic.
Basically. It's not limited, I mean, in terms of words, it's limited in terms of thinking.
And depth.
Because it's a kind of in-depth and also in originality, because it's a kind of standard, you know, a commodity. It's everything, you see one item in Wikipedia, you see the other one. Geography, short biography, main streets, main reasons. You have to stop. So, we thought that we want to think about the production of ideas, not about only the outcome. It gives some limited only information. So we kept going into this analysis. Also, we thought that we want to do this kind of dialogue with high culture and low culture, with popular culture. We cannot think this kind of dialogical investigation in Wikipedia. So it's mainly not an encyclopedia. It's a kind of encyclopedia or anti-encyclopedia, because it's one book about contemporary culture written in alphabetical order.
The form is encyclopedia, so, but it's one book. That's what David said. It's a book. We could have written it in a different way. We chose the form of encyclopedia because we think it's a very communicative way. One can understand easily how to find the material, the issue. One can find easily his way in such a huge book. But we don't intend to give information or data. It's not, there is lots of information, lots of data. But I think that our work, our success is in giving some interrelations, some connections, some deep investigation, I would even say, of culture today. So it's a form of encyclopedia.
And the aim, correct me if I'm wrong, is not to offer people knowledge, it's to encourage them to think and to go deep and to examine our reality.
I think we want them to see the limits of knowledge. I mean the limits of knowledge and the fact there is no kind of acceptance about what is the truth, what is knowledge. So we want to look in an ironic way upon this whole issue of knowledge, of objective knowledge, of scientific knowledge on the one hand. And on the other thinking, we want to offer the basic knowledge academically or analytically and then look at it with another way. Another gaze.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Who is the audience? When you were working on this, you probably thought about your target groups.
I'll tell you the truth. Maybe David thinks differently. I thought about our students in different schools we teach at, universities, colleges, etc. We thought about, people that it can be even a person in pupils in students in high schools, it can be students, it can be every other person that is interested in reality, in the way things are in our complex world. I wouldn't say that I have such a precise definition of target audience.
For example, do you need to have an academic background in order to comprehend?
Some of them, yes, I would say. Yes.
A minimal
maybe,
one.
Maybe, Talmud says, that way. I think yes. I don't think it's for non-educated people. I would like to non-educate people not to read this book.
That's
because
true.
You have to have basic education.
A minimal base.
That's true. But the variety of values and the variety of the systems of writing, I would say, is big. So there is quite a big portion of ideas, of values, that might be read by people which are not academic. Still, there are a lot of values that you won't bridge them if you don't know the language, if you don't know the... If you didn't study it at least, several years in an academic institution.
So even if we are dealing with such items like Jeep. I mean, the kind of car. How do you call it Jeep in English? We call it Jeep? Jeep, I mean...
Four-wheel drives.
How do you call it?
Jeep.
Okay. Yes, so it seems to be a very simple item, a popular item. We deal it with the language, with the symbolic language. We are dealing with the symbolism of the Jeep. I mean, this kind of machoism, kind of militarism, which is connected with this. We are thinking about the history of Jeep from this kind of machoistic and also very masochist, you know, target into a kind of vehicle of the yuppies. This kind of hammer, leading in the city, putting it on the pub, saying to the guys, here I am, I mean, I am big. So, we are talking in the symbolic language. We talk in the symbolic language, you have a minimal level of thinking, abstract thinking. So it's not kind of, you know, memorabilia or the kind of items.
Or trivia.
Yes, I mean, Jeep, this, that, that.
It's very comprehensive.
Yeah.
It's a comprehensive approach.
Yeah. So even the popular items are not really dealt with, you know, a kind of, let's have fun, but what does it mean? What does it tell about us, Israelis? What does it tell about people? Why the people are using the Jeep in the streets? Why they feel like, you know, so good with this kind of big, Mr. Big, being Mr. Big with the Jeep.
Maybe to compensate.
Yeah, maybe. That's the regular answer, but I think there are more. They want to compensate, they want to say that they have money, they have to say they are sexy, they want to say they are big, they want to say that everybody is low and they are big, and they also want to say that they want to die. I mean, they are young forever, because they are riding with the Jeep, like in a horse, like in a Western.
Wow.
And Danny, I called you Danny here, for the English version of this, very rightly, in our, you know, this kind of
launching show,
he put a Western. Somebody was, you know, just reading the item, this kind of value of a Jeep. And on the background, you see, you know, how do you call it?
A clip of cowboys of Clint Eastwood and the other cowboys which are riding in the Midwest and so on.
Riding into the sunset.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so they want to ride in the sunset with the Jeep and see the cowboys and cowgirls, you know, Israeli and international one.
Now, gentlemen, this is an Israeli encyclopedia written by two Israeli academics in Hebrew.
Yeah.
So one can safely assume that it's very much Israeli, but the question is how cosmopolitan this encyclopedia is, and you understand why I'm asking. I am asking about translating it to other languages.
It's an encyclopedia about Western culture today.
Mainly.
There are quite a bit of examples from our life, from our, you know, space, but it's not an Israeli encyclopedia, not at all. It's an encyclopedia about ideas that rule in the world today. Digital world, the commercial world.
It is an Israeli encyclopedia, but it's much more than that.
Yeah.
Are you aware of any similar encyclopedias that exist?
Not really know about it. I don't know. Not in English, I mean. Not in Hebrew. Of course not in Hebrew. No, in the other
Hebrew. I'm talking about all over the world.
All over the world. I didn't know, because encyclopedia is unique in a way, connecting things together. You know, the encyclopedia for philosophy, encyclopedia for science, and the cultural studies, encyclopedia for art. So they are very, you know, very strict encyclopedias in kind of methodologies and this kind of fields. We wanted this kind of
interdisciplinarity,
fusion.
Culture,
fields.
Thought, and media.
Yeah, mixing together.
Right.
And making somebody not only understand, but also feel by the examples, by the analysis we are proposing now. So it's unique in this way of analyzing texts, not only giving you kind of theories, some relatives. So we want to translate it, you know. It's not for the Hebrew speaker, man, it's for the international speaker. So we are very glad to have this interview in English, because we want, the sooner the better, to translate this encyclopedia, to make it available in English.
And you believe you have a message for the entire world?
Sure, more for the entire world than for the Israeli people.
Well, it's bigger.
Yes, of course.
Yeah. Again, talking about compensating.
Yeah, I mean, it is written as a cosmopolitan encyclopedia. There are only few items which are mainly Israeli, like post-Zionism. It also interests some people, you know, in abroad. There are some items like in Hebrew, south and way, and south and north, Darom, Tzafon, so it sounds very, you know, local. And also kind of periphery, center in Israel terms. Also post-colonialism, but also these terms are international ones. Everywhere you have this south and north problem. In Italy, in the States, you know how they call Rishon LeZion? Rishon LeZion is you know, the town in Israel. They have some place in Rishon LeZion, is the kind of Sasson town. They have this new north of Rishon LeZion, Tzafon HaChadash. And in Israel terms, so living in the Tzafon, meaning the north, yes, is the meaning living in a good neighborhood.
I see.
So Beersheba, which is way in the south,
yeah,
of Israel.
Like Tzfoni, like we say in Tel Aviv,
you are Tzfoni in Beersheba, Tzfoni, okay. More than one in Beersheba.
This, so, this is a social division.
Yeah, yeah, it's a social division. I just mentioned three or four items out of 600. So
amazing.
You can see that this kind of seeing things is very much, you know, international cosmopolitan.
Gentlemen, since one of the three main tracks or disciplinaries here is culture, mm-hmm, and our Facebook page is all about culture, may I take this opportunity to ask both of you for a short description. I know it's an unfair question, but I'm sure you will indulge me. A short description of the way you perceive the Israeli culture today.
I think, yes, it's a complicated question. I think there's no a kind of consensus, the definition of Israeli culture today. So the main characteristic of Israeli culture is this kind of heterogeneity. Not homogeneity, but heterogeneity. I mean, there are many tribes of Israelis. There's no such a thing to be in Israel, to be a sabra, to be, you know, this kind of fighter and farmer, like in the duration of this kind of, which we call in Hebrew, halutzim.
Pioneers,
yes. So there's no exception for us to be Israeli. Being Israeli, one version is being Israeli, like, you know, like Yapi, Israeli Yapi, like Yair Lapid, this kind of Israeli Yapi. Other version is Yishai. Other version is Bibi Netanyahu. Other version is Amos Oz. Another version is kind of post-Zionist. So what does it mean to be Israeli? One version is I think the Israelis are now approaching this kind of multicultural position. So there's no one definition for this culture.
There are
many
variety.
Cultures.
You are describing a great variety.
Yes, and I think one of the aim of Encyclopedia is approaching this kind of multicultural approach, seeing all the variety of the Israelis. I think it's not it's for the best, because we are enriched with this kind of variety, which means that we are many things of Israelis.
Basically, it's fusion, maybe even confusion.
Yeah, I think confusion is good, because confusion, we are making the right question. We are confused. We are desperate, we are confused. That's the way to begin things, no? Don't you think so? So if somebody will be desperate, confused with reading this Wikipedia, we are very pleased.
You are going back to ancient Greek with Socrates.
Yeah.
But the question is, can you talk about we? In such a confused situation, I refer
to both of us.
Okay, no, but when you talk about Israeli culture and you describe it in such a confused
there is no we. There are many
no
we.
Way.
There are many we. Yeah. Okay, there are many we. Okay, yeah. Of course. There are many tribes, I put it as many tribes, many
It's
friends.
True that if you have asked this question, let's say 10 years ago, I would have said, well, Israeli culture is looking for its way and it's in a
exploring.
Yeah, but nowadays I agree with David. It doesn't look for its way. We think because of our old, because of our traditional, that we should have one culture, one myth, and so on. But this has changed. This has changed. We really lived in a very, as you said, very confused but positive. Positive confusion.
It's a positive confusion.
Yeah, I think so.
Because it's responsible for a very enriched cultural creation, which is making, by the way, and I'm using a term from your, a value from your encyclopedia, making lots of buzz all over the world.
Yeah. Sure. Because everything which is creative is out of conflict. Nothing is going out without the conflicts. So we have many conflicts here. So that's why there's a rich society, rich in spirit, you know, rich in thinking. And I don't afraid the word conflicts. Well, the word we have to be afraid of is consensus. Because, as Danny put it, every consensus is a kind of depression. It's a kind of repression.
And decadence.
And decadence, because somebody's paying. I mean, something for this kind of, you know, peace. In a way, conflicts makes things creative. It puts things and making new things. Back into Heraclitus. Everything which is good, a kind of, you know, fire and water, sun and the moon, etc. So it's kind of
the contradictions. The contradictions.
Yeah, the contradictions make the world. Of course, the contradiction makes also violence. But violence is a part of the creation, isn't it? It's kind of Nietzschean way of thinking, if you want.
And your encyclopedia was received in a very interesting way last week in Savta. With a beautiful cultural evening.
Yeah, we decided to launch our project in a special way. We think that the book is special. Sorry for not being very generous, very modest.
You are allowed.
And we thought that we should launch it in a special way. We mobilized some of our fans, which are actors and
singers,
actors.
Some of the best in Israel.
Some of the Israeli celebrities.
Right. It was a very special event.
Yeah, and we thought because of this confused way, because of this interdisciplinary way we think about culture, we thought that it would be worthwhile if we'll give actors to deal with these values, to give artists to see what they can do with these values, not only the academics, not only the scholars. Let's go to the popular culture and see how the popular culture deals with some of these.
And how was it?
I think it was superb. I think
it was a full house.
Of course. Many people went home with no tickets. Oh yeah, it was
very happy. Everything was okay. Sold out. You know, like a show sold out. Everything was sold.
Yeah. Excellent.
And also, I think going back to Danny's friends. The interesting thing that they do understand by their interpretation, the inner thing of the encyclopedia, meaning dealing with the language.
Yeah.
And for example, when they read this kind of like a value, like a garbage junk, it was interesting. It was new for us. It was something which is not written, but it was written. Yeah. It's kind of the interpretation of the new things. In a way, that's our aim, to put away the many ways you can deal with words. We wanted this kind of bliss of reading, this kind of jouissance, as he put it in French. I mean, that somebody will enjoy himself while reading it and extend the words, extend the metaphor, extend many of the texts are here, the poems, you know, the kind of motus you have noticed, and other, you know, items which are, you know, kind of having a dialogue with the main text. I wanted also the reader to practice this kind of writing, this kind of many, many levels of language, and make his own language while reading it.
Interesting. Did you manage to get already some reactions from your peers, from your students?
Not really, not really.
When can we expect the first review?
The first reviews, I think, in 2 weeks or 3 weeks.
Yes.
We got many, you know, many people said that it's impressive, but I won't say that I got really a deep criticism yet. I've got a friend which is a scientist in the Weizmann Institute. I was very afraid that he would have things to say because we deal here with quite a lot of scientific ideas, and we connect them with culture. Let's say we talked about
chaos theory,
about
quantum theory.
Yeah,
we look at the string theory.
He's a professional in the quantum theory, and I gave him the book, and it was in some of our ideas back 6 years ago or something, but still. The values have changed, and I didn't know. And this morning I met him. He said, "Listen, no mistake, nothing."
Hey, so the ultimate compliment.
He's a professor.
We did our homework.
You passed the test.
Yeah. So hearing it from him, which is it's not in the humanity. It is totally scientist. And he dealt with values, and he realized what we have tried to say, not only in the scientific level, but in the cultural level. So it was a good reaction.
Excellent.
Yeah, sure. Also, all these kind of scientific issues, we wanted to say this kind of cultural angle about them. See, not only writing a paper in quantum theory.
Of course.
But we wanted to. For example,
to put it in a context, everything is in a context.
Of determinism or anti-determinism of thinking. It's kind of something which is one thing and another at the same time. And what does it mean cultural? So this is a context, a cultural context. That's basically our mandate was to write about culture.
Amazing. Gentlemen, I want to thank you.
Thank you.
First
much.
Of all, for the encyclopedia. Second, for taking the time. And I want to wish you all the success in the world, that many will find this helpful and useful in making our lives a little bit more clear, and hopefully also the international community will show interest in that, and hopefully one day it will be translated to many languages. I just want to make a wish. This encyclopedia will not suffer from the fate as the encyclopedia in the famous joke. You know the joke?
No.
A guy got married, he published an ad on the internet.
Okay.
Encyclopedia Britannica for sale. Just got married. Wife knows everything. And I suspect that this will not happen to your encyclopedia.
Let's be optimistic.
Toda rabba, good luck.
Thanks very much.
Shalom, shalom.
Thank you.